Imagine for a moment that you had two identical billiard ball tables. And the cue ball, which here I've outlined in red, is hit in the exact same way with the exact same amount of force in the same direction on both tables. Then, if those two tables are exactly identical, that means that everything that happens after that on both tables should be exactly the same. Now imagine you just have one table. The same basic principle applies. Once that initial hit happens, everything that happens after that is predetermined based on that initial situation. If you have the initial situation of the billiard balls, the initial strike, the initial force, if that's set, then everything that happens after that is based on that initial situation and the initial strike. Now, the universe is not made of billiard balls, but it is made of atoms. And atoms, in many ways, act like billiard balls. They bounce off of each other, etc. And so, philosophers got to thinking that if the universe started out with some collection of atoms in some situation, and that some amount of force got the whole thing going, then everything that happens after that is predetermined from that very beginning moment. In other words, every single thing that happens now was already determined by the very beginning of the universe. And that idea is called determinism. Now, you might say, well, I could choose to do something totally random right now, but a determinist would argue that that thought that you're going to do something totally random and crazy right now, that thought itself was determined right at the beginning of the universe based on the position of the atoms and all that kind of stuff. So, is there a way around it? Can we have free will in a world of determinism? Well, let's find out.